what a wonderful day it is today. I love being by the water. I love seeing all those ducks and the birds flying. And, ooh, look at those little children. They're splashing in the water with their toes, hoping to get some attention from those ducks. Well, let's see. The giant should be here any moment. We have a cool news story to tell today. And I wonder where he could be. Let me kind of walk this way toward that weeping willow. Boy, is it pretty. I wonder where he is. Gosh, I don't see him on the bicycle path. I don't see him jogging. I wonder where he could be. Oh my, look at that. Is he actually in a rowboat? And who do you have with you on that boat? I see your two bird friends.
Oh, I'm soaking wet. I fell off the boat a couple times. Hey, how do you like my boat, by the way?
I love that. I mean, gosh, you got to be exhausted rowing that boat.
Yeah, I got it at Boats R Us. Oh, Billy wanted to go swimming. Well, I wanted to take Billy swimming.
Yeah, but pigeons don't swim.
Yeah, well, I know that now, but I didn't know that. He didn't like it very much.
Yeah, but I'll bet you he had a good time riding on the boat with you when you were right side up.
He did. No, he really had a good time in the boat. I tried to show him the ducks, and he didn't care.
Yeah.
I tried to show him the seagulls. He said, well, they're not in the water either.
Yeah.
And then I saw the sparrows and the other birds, and, you know, I figured, okay, so some birds like the water and some birds don't like the water, huh?
I know, exactly.
Well, there's a difference, I guess, between what somebody wants and what somebody needs.
Oh, certainly, for sure. Yeah.
Hey, isn't that the story we're going to read today?
Yep, it most certainly is.
This is one of your stories.
Yeah.
A story written by you, Robin MacBlane.
To want is not to need.
And vice versa.
Yeah. Give me that. I want it, Andrea heard a voice demand. She looked in the direction of the voice. She saw a girl just about her own age tugging at a stuffed animal an older lady was holding.
The lady pulled the stuffed animal from the girl's hand and placed it back on the store shelf. Andrea watched the girl. The girl crossed her arms in front of her and stomped her foot as hard as she could against the floor. The girl looked very sternly at the lady.
That lady must be her mother, Andrea thought to herself. Boy, is she ever going to get it.
Andrea saw the lady saying something to the little girl. The lady said it very softly, so Andrea couldn't hear what she was saying.
Andrea then saw the girl stomp her foot again and heard her say, "But I want it now." Andrea saw the lady shake her head no. She watched as the lady took the girl by the hand and led her down the aisle, away from the stuffed animals. Andrea could hear the girl yelling even as she and the lady were out of sight.
"We're finished, Andrea. Time to go," Andrea heard her mother say. Andrea pushed the cart out of the store as her mother walked beside her.
"Mom, did you hear that girl yelling while we stood in line?" Andrea asked her mother as they reached their car.
"I sure did, Andrea," replied her mother as she unlocked the car door. Andrea helped her mother place the groceries in the car. What was she yelling about?
I guess because she wanted a stuffed animal and the lady she was with told her she couldn't have it.
Andrea paused. She spotted the girl and her mother exiting the store. Andrea's eyes grew wide in amazement.
"Mom, look!" Andrea exclaimed.
Andrea's mother looked in the direction Andrea was pointing. "Is that the girl, Andrea?" Andrea's mother asked.
"Yes, Mom, and look what she's carrying. The stuffed animal I saw her mom put back on the shelf," Andrea said with amazement in her eyes.
Andrea and her mother both got in their car. After buckling their seatbelts, Andrea's mother started up the car engine and drove the car into the street, heading toward their home.
"Mom," Andrea began curiously, "why do you suppose that lady bought that stuffed animal for her, especially after she yelled so much?"
"I don't know, Andrea," replied her mother. "I suppose some parents think that if they give their children whatever they want, their children will love them more, even if they don't need what they want."
Andrea thought for a while. What's the difference between want and need, Mom? Andrea asked inquisitively.
Well, something that you want doesn't mean that it's something you need, replied her mother. And something that you need doesn't mean that it's something you want.
I don't understand, Mom. Andrea was confused.
Oh, I'm sorry, Andrea. Andrea's mother laughed. I'll explain it better. You act so grown up sometimes that I forget you're only 8.
Andrea smiled. It always made her feel good when her parents treated her like an adult.
To get something that you want is to have something that you really like, just like the doll your dad and I gave you for your birthday. You really didn't need that doll because you had other dolls, but you really liked it. You wanted it, so we got it for you.
Andrea's mother looked at Andrea. Andrea was listening attentively.
To get something that you need is to have something that helps you survive in this world, like food. Your body needs food to live. Without food, your body would die.
Andrea interrupted. But Mom, you said before that something you need doesn't mean that you want it. I want food because I like it. What is it that I don't like that I need? Andrea asked.
Think of something that you do twice a year that you don't really like doing, but your body needs it to stay healthy, Andrea's mother replied.
Andrea thought for a moment. I know, exclaimed Andrea, looking at her mother lovingly. The dentist! I don't like going to the dentist, but I need to go to keep my teeth healthy. Gosh, Mom, you're so smart. I'm glad I have a mom like you.
Andrea's mother smiled. She reached over and patted Andrea on the leg. And I'm glad I have a daughter like you, Andrea's mother said proudly as they entered their driveway. Come on, let's unload these groceries and then go get your doll. I feel like having a tea party, Andrea's mother said excitedly. Don't you?
She looked at her daughter with loving eyes. Andrea grinned as she helped her mother take the groceries into the house. The end.
Short story, Robin.
Yeah, most certainly was. But boy, I love these stories for our storybook railroad.
Yeah, me too. Hey, how about you ducks? Did you like that story?
Yeah, boy. I think they did. Look at them. They're just flapping their wings in the water, just having a good time staying clean.
Hey, Billy, I think I figured out why you don't like the water.
Oh, and why is that?
Looks like his feathers aren't made the same way as those ducks. Look, the water just rolls off of those duck feathers.
Yeah, they most certainly do. But, one duck splashed Billy. Maybe he'll get brave and go in.
Hey, how about you? You feel like getting in my boat? Want to go for a ride?
Oh, yeah, I'd love it.
All right, come on down carefully. I got to hold your hand. Come on, just step down this rock and then this other rock.
Uh-oh,
oh, don't slip on the mud there.
Oh, no.
Watch out.
Here we go.
Oh, come on. All right.
No. All right,
come on. Easy. There you go. Lower your butt.
Okay, there I am.
All right.
In the boat.
Oh. All right. It's going to start rowing, all right?
Okay.
Now you got a song? Row, row, row your boat gently in the lake. Merrily, 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 merrily. Life is not a mistake.
There you go.
You got to do it with me.
Ready? Oh, okay.
Ready?
Okay.
You got to do it like in a counter time or whatever they call it.
Okay.
Ready? Row, row, row your boat gently down the lake. Merrily, 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 merrily. Life is not a mistake.
Merrily, merrily, merrily. Life is not a mistake.
Row, row, row your boat gently in the lake. Merrily, 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 merrily.
Life is not a mistake.
Hey!
Billy, it's fun right there.